CBS News and the New York Times polled 1,000 Americans, blue-collar and business owners, from Idaho to New York. We found deep pessimism about the economy and Washington's attempts to fix it.
There's not a lot of good coming out of Washington right now.
Just 15% of those polled approve of the job Congress is doing. That's close to an all-time low.
Right now, no, I don't really trust them.
And only 29% think the GOP is trying to work with the president, while 62% think Mr. Obama is reaching across the aisle.
If Democrats and Republicans aren't going to find the middle of the road, then maybe we do need a third party.
His frustration helps explain why nearly 20% of those surveyed now consider themselves members of the Tea Party movement. Who are they? According to the poll, 95% are white. They are just as likely as Americans overall to have college educations and to make over $50,000 a year. And like Cuna, Idaho coffee shop owner Jared Hatch, they are more likely to identify themselves as Republicans than independents or Democrats.
This Tea Party movement is, I think, a great thing. It goes to show that the people aren't just going to stand for what the elected officials are going with.
But for more than half the country, the Tea Party movement remains a relative mystery. How about you? I'm sorry. Can you tell me what you know about the Tea Party?
I know that it's a right-wing kind of conservative movement right now.
I know that Sarah Palin is associated with the Tea Party, but other than that,
from what I've seen in them, they look pretty angry.
Still, the Tea Party mentality is spreading. 56% of everyone polled said they'd prefer a smaller government, providing fewer services. That's the highest percentage in more than a decade.
I don't feel like it's the government's responsibility to bail out certain segments of the population.
In fact, concern about government spending is so great that a majority of Americans, 53%, now believe the U.S. cannot afford to fix health care at this time. Katie?
Nancy Cordes reporting and ambushing people around the nation's capital. Thanks so much, Nancy.